welcome to ATV News. My name is Shalama Lawson. On tonight's bulletin, water shortages affect farmers in Guruve. Women in Bulawayo start self-help projects. A disabled school receives goods on Mandela Day. And in sport, Highlanders face stiff competition. As water shortages in Guruve continue to intensify, farmers in the district are now walking long distances to fetch water from the nearest wells in order to maintain their gardens. Jeffrey Moyo gives us the story.
Farmers in Guruve, some 150 kilometers from Harare, are experiencing acute water shortages, forcing them to scale down their crop and gardening activities. ATV visited the area and spoke to some affected farmers. The farmers are using organic fertilizers as opposed to inorganic fertilizers, and farmers speak about the benefits of organic fertilizers. Environment Africa Country Director said his organization is committed to alleviating water problems facing farmers in Guruve.
Safamba yedu tichiona kumapindo aya taona dambudziko remvura ririko zvikuru. Saka naizvozvo tinokukumbirai kuti vemapindo iwayo muise misoro pamwechete munyore ma proposals. Tobatsirana kufamba nema proposals aya tichipemha kune vangakwanise kubatsira kuti paive nemvura.
Meanwhile, agricultural extension service providers encouraged farmers to practice crop rotation to prevent pest diseases.
Tiri pa crop rotation nika inobatsira kuvarimi. Inovabatsira ivo kuti ivuravo chaivo pa ivuravo raushandisa ivo panzvimbo yavari kushandira. Chinoitika ndechekuti ivuroro richange rakaita sei rakabatana. Erosion inoita ishoma.
Reporting for ATV, I'm Jeffrey Moyo in Guruve, Zimbabwe.
Females in Zimbabwe remain marginalized when it comes to economic empowerment, but some Bulawayo women have launched a self-help project to help change the status quo. Eunice Faradai spoke to some members of the group about their work.
A group of women belonging to the Bulawayo Informal Traders Association have embarked on income-generating projects to improve their livelihoods. ATV crew spoke to the women at their monthly meeting to learn more about their work.
Tina njenga bo mama abezichiya ngithola ukuthi omama bonke ngihlangana labo lapha ngabo mama abakhaliphileyo abalothando lokuzenzela imisebenzi yabo yezandla njalo kabadondi omama laba abakhathalekile ukuthi imali iyaswelakala kodwa bayazama ngemizamo yonke khonoko okuncane abakutholayo bayazama ukuthi baphilise abantu babo ngakho
kube ngumama okhutheleyo. And want to mama always cheer, ukon mama, or look at Sakabangela Paz. Is it here was wrong, mamma, shagan play? Ubeling on the escan play, we was in a witty Nanza song, a tall pillar, nitty, sing a pillar, Mugan. Ubagadis is a tatuity when we are going a lap plan, or some to look to Melubaba.
Apart from discussing business, the women also tackle other issues affecting women.
Menajongo mama was a cheer, is a cheer, so we can attend like a cool. Isimpathise ezintweni eziningi like nxa silezifundo sengikwazi ukuthi abantwana bami baphathwa njani ngkhaya, sengikwazi ukuthi amalungelo ami ngasebenzisa njani ngkhaya lemsebenzini.
So siyafundisana ukuba ngumama ukuthi nxa ungumama okwangikhaya ukuthi kumele ngikhaya uziphathe njani, kumele uphathe njani abantu abakho, kumele uphathe njani umkakho. Sifundisane njalo lezinto ezinjenge zabo HIV and AIDS. Sifundisane lama siyayenza lama workshop.
Mina izichiya ingcwadi sekakhulu Bengingu mama lapha enhlala khona umama olenhloni ukuthi ngeke mfake itamatisi phambi kwegedi lami. Bona ngani kuyanyangisa, bona ngani akungamphathi kuhle. Kodwa ngiyenele ukujoyina izishiya asengu number 1.
The women also have a burial society where they contribute subscriptions on a monthly basis.
Siyacha imali yethu. Imali siyana iyabi izala ngemva kwesikhathi. Siyathi njenga last lay session at the CBU, we see usually after 2 weeks.
For many years, women have been sidelined in economic empowerment projects, but now things have changed with more and more women playing an active role in the country's economy. Reporting for ATV in Bulawayo, Zimbabwe.
As Nelson Mandela's 94th birthday was celebrated on Wednesday, the South African Embassy donated goods to Danigo College, a school for the disabled. Robert Tafumane was at the event.
As Zimbabwe joined the rest of the world to celebrate Nelson Mandela's 94th birthday, the South African Embassy on Wednesday donated goods to a school for the disabled as part of the festivities. Every year, people around the world do acts of charity for 67 minutes to commemorate Mandela Day.
Sacrificed 67 years of his life, dedicated to the good of humanity, dedicated to the liberation, not only of the people of South Africa. Mandela dedicated himself to the liberation of the people of the continent and the region.
Danigo staff and students expressed gratitude to the embassy for choosing to celebrate Mandela Day with the underprivileged.
We feel greatly honored by to be chosen like this by the South African Embassy in Zimbabwe. Among all the institutions and the people they could have chosen to celebrate the birthday of this great man of South Africa, of the region, of Africa and the world, Mr. Nelson Mandela's birthday. It's really a great honor to be remembered on such a day for our children and for us as an institution.
We have enjoyed the birthday because we have met various people today to celebrate with us to the birthday for the a struggler who took his life 27 years in jail for us to have a life that is enjoyable.
Nelson Mandela is a brave man, a great and courageous, because he sacrificed his life in jail. Kuti isu sitiwane freedom and then akawenza freedom akawenza peace munitions.
In 2009, the United Nations agreed to commemorate Mandela's birthday every year in recognition of his contribution to resolving conflicts and promoting race relations, human rights and reconciliation. Reporting for ATV, Robert Afmani, Harare, Zimbabwe.
The race for the Castle League Championship is hotting up as the Highlanders' chances in the competition are fading. This week, Boso take on Harare Giants, Dynamos, in another battle for the title. Crispin Tabura reports.
Blois recently promoted Castle Lager League newcomer Queleton Football Club last weekend became the second team to challenge Highlanders' chances of becoming league champions after a 1-1 draw. 2 weeks ago, Highlanders was held to a 1-1 draw by another newcomer, Harare City, in a match marred by violence. Queleton's head coach was optimistic that his team would stay in the league and give Highlanders a run for its money.
One thing that you have to put in mind, given Dynamo's tough time, Highlanders' tough time, that's where I need to show the people that I can think I'm a good coach.
Highlanders' head coach said his team was preparing to defend its title against its biggest opponent, Dynamos, as they clash this weekend.
We respect them like any other opponents. Every game that we play is the same. We know they're a big team and we know the tension which is there, but we'll train the way we always train.
So far, champion Tinotora, Neguti, Artis, Nagunyanya, Gwendakur, Energy. Ne Highlanders, ne kuti kozvino zvine 4 games dzadza tamba dzaka izwa zvishamisa iri kudzokera kuti mbai
ibhora pera rere ndota even yona idimbare tinga draw onke ama game lawo ayi 4 kumbe singayichaya thina I draw angu 2 so akuzakali sizabona layo but thina asisabi lingayekela ukudlala forever siyalidla phela.
Meanwhile, police are confident of providing a safe environment when Zimbabwe's Giants, Highlanders and Dynamos clash in a crunch league game at Baba Field Stadium this Sunday. Reporting for ATV, I'm Chris Pentavra at Baba Field Stadium in Bulawayo, Zimbabwe.
Thank you for joining us. Good night.